Welcome to Nitro Party number 10. We're in Jacksonville, Florida. We start hot with Lil Pepe in a cute clown outfit. Mongo says it's in honor of all the clowns here, like Jimmy Hart. Then Bischoff says to call in tonight because we picked the main event. So apparently picked someone from the red locker room, where there's Flair, Ming, DDP, the Blue Bloods, Bubba, Shark, and Scott Norton. Then you pick the blue locker. Sting, Johnny B. Badd, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, Dave Sullivan, Alex Wright, the Nasty Boys, and JL. Wouldn't it be hilarious if we got Alex Wright versus the Nasty Boys? Ooh, Shark versus Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Why not? I assume they're going to manipulate this somehow so we get Sting and Flair. Then again, they probably don't have to. That does feel like the popular choice. In all honesty, that's what I would pick too. We get more replays of the Yeti. I really love how proud they are of that thing. Always believe in the things you create. Macho Man is tearing apart the locker room. I assume that's just the normal behavior of a man permanently dialed to 11. The venue starts playing Kevin's theme and then changes to Cobra's weird-ass Morse code. Tonight he's got a WCW World Heavyweight title match, even though Bischoff says it's not a title match. I don't know. That aside, what are Cobra's credentials for this match? Why does he deserve a world title match? I don't think it's gonna matter though. And it doesn't. One choke slam and over in 16 seconds. Cool. Gene says to call and book a match. Shark and Norton are still in each other's faces from last week. I love that continuity. In the red locker room, we have audio-visual issues. Hacksaw's having a blast, though. Alex Wright really doesn't care. We get a World War III promo. Three rings with 60 people. It's going to be absolutely impossible to keep up with. Which commentator do you think is going to get confused first? We immediately cut to a guy playing guitar and singing a song. Apparently, we're at Venice Beach with Hogan and Macho Man. And the guy in between them that Hogan describes as his guru. Everyone's just feeling the vibes, man. Hogan starts talking about prayers and vitamins. Then he mentions Macho Man joined the dark side. But then staying on brand, he calls the giant stinky, nasty, wart-infested. Hogan, you weirdo. Macho Man then tells Hogan to calm down. You have any idea how crazy things have to be for Macho Man to be the one to say calm down? We transition back to Jacksonville with Kevin. Hey, Kevin's gonna be wrestling the Renegade. Cool. Renegade sprints to the ring and mows Kevin down on his ass. He just gets overwhelmed. Jimmy Hart runs distraction outside screaming in his megaphone. Heenan then updates us that last week, his mean was to secure more Japanese talent. Thanks, Heenan. That's really cool of you. Kevin Sullivan hits the top rope stomp and gets the win. Jimmy Hart then runs in the ring and wipes off the Renegade's face paint. This company just loves bullying this poor man. Jimmy says, "You're not a Renegade. You're just plain old Rick, a nobody. You're nothing." Real gross to see. Legitimately disgusting. Like, not even in a wrestling way. Just terrible, dude. We cut to Gene and let's say the blue locker. The lights go out and then they come back on super bright. Flair saves it by saying he controls the lights like he controls everything here. The dude is amazing on the microphone. You all know that though. Don't think there's many non-wrestling fans watching a WCW breakdown. WCW Saturday night should be fun. Look, there's disco. And Hacksaw goes to Ireland. What fun. Time for Benoit versus Guerrero. This should be a fun time. And is it ever? These guys can just go. I know I say that every single time, but man, it's great. Like, how can it be? This fledgling cruiserweight division are some of the best wrestlers in the world at the time. Hell, still some of the best wrestlers today. Speaking of, Bischoff says they're playing the cruiserweight division. And then commentaries talk about the match, really putting the action over. The camera cuts away to a table of Japanese men waiting. Sitting there, you see, and if anyone knows 90s New Japan Pro Wrestling, feel free to correct me, Masahiro Chono, Mr. Torture, Masa Saito, Kensuke Sasaki, and Jushin Thunder Liger. They're all watching the action. Please have them wrestle soon. Please. Please have them on Nitro. I cannot stress how happy I am right now. We cut back to the match and they spilled outside the ring. The match ends with Benoit's legs fully under the ropes as Guerrero gets the pin. Heenan loses his mind that the ref isn't paying attention. But never mind that, we cut back to a locker room. Maybe the blue one. I don't know which is which anymore. They keep talking about Flair versus Sting. They cut promos on each other and everything. It's definitely happening tonight. It is the most popular match though. If it was anything else, I'd be really surprised. Tomorrow the VHS of Fall Brawl comes out. Check your local store and see if they'll look in the back for you. We all know they have a copy sitting back there waiting for you. Heenan is drinking sake while we're told the main event will be Sting versus Flair. Sting comes out to the ring and then Flair comes out without a robe. It's really weird to see Flair coming out without a robe. Match is exactly what you'd expect though. It's great. Both guys are legends for a reason. So Rick gets the figure four on and works the ropes. They just play it like a classic heel face matchup. Sting stings up and breaks a submission. After that, Sting just lays into him until Flair starts cheating. He shoves the ref though, and the ref shoves them back. Ref didn't come here to take shit today. Bischoff says we'll have some big news after the match. After a whole night of some great wrestling, I'm ready for nonsense. The ref tried to separate Sting and Flair, so Sting carries the ref away, and Flair pulls out brass knucks. Flair punches him and gets the pin. Wait, no. Sting ain't going down like that. Not tonight. Sting slaps on the Scorpion Deathlock, and Flair actually taps. Another solid match. Then JL, Hacksaw, Bad, and Guerrero run out to the ring to give him the break the hold. Sting isn't letting go. Then Doug Dillinger hits the ring and gets order restored. Double D hit the scene, baby. Sting runs back in to apply the hold, and Luger comes out. Luger talks to Sting. Sting breaks the hold, and they walk back together. Hacksaw is very confused what he just saw. But yeah, let's see where this goes. Got some real interesting story threads going tonight. And now it's time for the big announcement. Gene is in the ring with the Giant, Kevin, and Jimmy Hart. Jimmy altered the contract. He says this is because he's Hogan's power of attorney. That adds a whole other layer to the story. Why is Jimmy Hart Hogan's power of attorney? Is Jimmy Hart making medical decisions? How far does Jimmy Hart's power go? Anyway, Jimmy added the clause that if Hogan lost by DQ, then he'd lose the title. And I am still super confused how Hogan lost by DQ. He was the only person not cheating at the end. I'm not a Hogan fan at all, but the dude got hit by the belt twice, and then an entire stable jumped him in the ring. He also got humped by the Yeti, suddenly everyone's favorite member of the WCW legal team, Nick Lambros, enters the ring. He's been talking to the championship committee, the same people that presumably gave Cobra a title match tonight, so obviously they know what they're doing. Nick says Hart is partially correct. He did have the authority to sign, but the Giant is not the world champion. WCW Commissioner Nick Bockwinkel says the contract says he'd lose the belt, but because of the dubious nature of the ending, the title will be awarded to the winner of World War III. So if the contract could not be held up, that means the Giant was never champ, right? Like, that means the contract would be null and void. Like, I get they're not going to retroactively take the Giant's reign away. It feels like that really shouldn't count, especially when everyone's been telling you for weeks he's not really the champion. Oh, well, that's just how I feel. Kevin gives the belt back to the lawyer and says they'll just win it at World War III. That really makes this pay-per-view a lot more interesting. Next week, Macho Man vs. Meng, Guerrero vs. Giant Be Bad in a title match, and Sting vs. Dean Malenko. Hell yeah, brother. I'm actually excited again. And I know the last time I got excited, we had the Chicago show. That was a complete mess. But this feels different. I don't know why, it just does. But yeah, the last month was real rough, but this is a nice rebound. Hopefully they can carry us momentum, because we're on the road to World War III. Thank you for watching.